I'm Will Greenwald, Senior Consumer Electronics Analyst at PCMag.com, and this little box is a Boxo Lasers. It is the Wicked Lasers Laser Cube, and it is a portable laser projector. It's not a projector like you might think. This isn't a Pico projector where I can cast my screen to the wall or a video game console or anything like that. No, it is just lasers. This uses three diodes with a total power of the standard version, 499, is 800 milliwatts, and the Pro version, 599, is 1 full watt total power of shining lasers. That doesn't sound like a whole lot, it's just 1 watt, but when you think that the tiny laser pointers you can get at like a drugstore or a pet store are just 5 milliwatts, this is 200 times the power. And even this is a 60th the power of a professional engraving laser, which is the size of this table. This is a tiny, portable, battery-powered laser projector that lets you show laser light shows, play games, listen to music with cool effects, and even engrave some things with it. And I'm going to show you how it works. I'm running this software called LaserOS. Everything needs to be controlled through LaserOS, either through a computer or a cell phone or a tablet. It's an app or program that lets you set basically what this shows off. Lots of different graphics that do a lot of different goofy things, but this is just the simple stuff you can do. Still photos, fine. How about animations? Go to the animation section and a globe. Or how about a wine bottle? And because it's basically vector graphics, it can give a cool, you know, 3D effect. Obviously not actual 3D, it isn't processing 3D graphics, but just taking really bright lines against a black background and animating them in the right way, you can cause a really cool effect like that, like the arcade game Tempest. You can also have airplane. This defaults to a bunch of different sort of effects, because the idea is you're gonna use this if you're a DJ or a performer, and you want to have something cool shining in the background. The lasers can get much larger than this and just put it across a whole wall so you can have things happening when you're playing music. So I can set this to a visualizer. And let me just, is the microphone array on? It should be. Yeah, see, now it's going to with my voice. And I can sync it with whatever music's playing, any audio device on this, and it will do a light show in time with the beat of whatever I'm doing. So if you're a DJ, that's kind of a big boon for this. And it's a lot smaller than most laser projectors of this kind that you'll find. And it's battery powered. It's plugged in right now because, well, we need to make sure it's running for this video, but it can last 2 to 3 hours just without this. It doesn't connect wirelessly though. You do need a USB connection to your phone or notebook. These are really simple arcade games, sort of all but in name classic arcade games like Spy Hunter, Pac-Man, Asteroids, Space Invaders. This isn't a great game. Let's try something else. How about some Laseroids? In harp mode, it sets these dots, but if you have like a smoke machine or any sort of just kind of cloudiness in the air, a fog machine, it lets you see the beams, and then putting your hands in front of the beams, a camera watching this will say, oh, I'm blocking these beams, and then each beam you block is a different note, so you can kind of play it like a harp. Now, one of the coolest parts of this, I cannot show right now because it would start a fire, and I'm not being hyperbolic about that. I mean, it's actually designed to burn things. This is a burning function, so you can use it to etch woods, leathers, possibly light acrylics, but this, again, is not nearly as powerful as professional burning lasers that are much bigger, much more expensive. But I've made some neat little coasters and plaques and just things with bits of wood, so it does burn. Now, the annoying part here is the software. It is kind of buggy and awkward to use. You gotta wrestle with it to get what you want out of this, and basically you're gonna be doing a lot of experimenting with projector placement, alignment settings to get the most out of what you're projecting or burning or just playing with, which is a bit of a pain, but you know, if you're of the mind to do that, it's totally doable. This is not a broken device at all. You can definitely get cool things to happen. Besides that, it isn't the most attractive or streamlined device. Wicked Lasers, their pointers are known for being like cool lightsaber-like designs, so this is just the most stark, plain projector they could possibly put out where it's just a black cube, which, they could have done a little bit more. The Wicked Lasers Laser Cube is a pretty unique device. I mean, there are laser show projectors, there are burning lasers, there are a bunch of things kind of like this, but this is like a jack of all trades light box that doesn't do anything really perfectly, but it does a lot of cool things that you can play with. And if you're a hobbyist, if you're willing to spend half a grand on a laser that can burn and, you know, play little arcade games and show stuff and be a music visualizer, just do a bunch of things and are willing to play with those modes, it's a pretty neat hobbyist device.